Today is Monday, October the 14th, 2024. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how I trade a system on the S&P 500 index options, and I call it buy low, buy high. So it consists of just four simple points. The first point is I wait for the market to be open for 15 minutes. I'm in the central US time zone, so right now it's 8:30 a.m. All the times shown on my screen are in central US time. So that means that the market just opened and I'm going to wait until 8:45 a.m. Because at that point it will have been open for 15 minutes. And at that point, SPX will already have established a low of day and a high of day. From that point forward, I will look for instances where SPX falls below the low of the day. And at that point, I'm going to buy a call, and I'll buy that call on the strike that's closest to the new low of day. Once I'm in the position, I'll try to sell that call back to the market for a dollar of profit. Similarly, if it rises above the high of day, I'll buy a put. Once I'm in the put, I'll try to get out of it for a dollar of profit. And as far as risk management is concerned, if the position loses $5 in value, I'll close it out and move on to another position. That last item is probably the trickiest part of this. If a trade does go wrong, it's not exactly clear where to get out of the trade. Sometimes the value of the contract that I buy might drop by $2 or $3, and then it rebounds and eventually goes back to break even or even makes a profit. So where exactly to get out is a little bit nuanced. All right, so that's the entire system right there. At this point, I just need to wait another 13 minutes. And at that point, I'll start looking for trades to put on. All right, so should flip over to 8:45 here pretty soon. And so far we have a low in SPX at 29.57 and a high at 41.42. So it looks like the first trade of the day is going to be a break above 41.42, in which case I'll try to get into a put on the 58.45. All right, looks like we're here now, so go in. Got my order working. So the price that I put in was 11:30, and currently that contract is trading at 11:70. So I won't chase it. I'll just let the market come to my price. And filled. So now I want to look to get out at 12:30. All right, so while I am monitoring this existing trade, I'll have my eye on the next trade, which might present itself in terms of being able to get in on the 58.50. So the new high is at 58.45.28. I'll queue up a ticket to get ready for that. So there's a break above the 45.28. Looks like it ticked just a little bit higher. So got filled here at 12.50. And I'll be looking to get out at 13.50. Keeping my eye on the first position at 45 as well. So this first position looks like it's getting close to being stopped out at a $5 loss. When this gets to negative 2,500, that's what a $5 loss looks like, since I'm in five contracts. So I'm going to go ahead and take the next break above the high of the day. The current high of the day is 51.76. I'll try to get into the 55. And at that point, this 45 will probably be time to close it. There it is. All right, so got a fill here at 1090. Looking to get out of that one at 1190. And this first position here looks like it's on the brink. Okay, so there's a $5 loss there. So I'm gonna look to get out of this at a $5 loss or better. The second position too is another $5 loss, so I need to get out of both of those at $5 loss or better. All right, so the 55 trade was at 1090, looking to get out at 1190. And I won't push the button until I see it on the screen. There it is. All right, so back to the 50 and the 45. Both of these hit the max loss level at negative $5. And I'm looking for an exit here. All right, I think I've definitely seen enough out of this first position. So I'm going to go ahead and close it out. Okay, that's gone. Still just looking here for an exit on this second position as it did hit the $5 max loss. The question is where to get out since it did retreat from the max loss. There still may be an opportunity to get out at less than $5 loss. Let's see this. The 50 was put on at 1250. So 750 would be the $5 max loss. All right, so I'm gonna part company with this position at 850. Now looking for a break above 54.25. So I'm going to put in a alert to alert me when we hit 58.53.25. Put that in as greater than. And down at the other end, I'll put in an alert at 58.30.57. All right, there's the alert. So look to get into the 55. If we break 54.25. There it is. So got filled at 790, looking to get out at 890. Won't push the button until I actually see 890 or better on the screen. I think I saw it briefly there, then it dropped back to 80, there it is. All right, new high at 54.80. So a new high at 5480 would put me back in the 55 potentially. However, I've already had that makes two trades at the 55. And while it's not really a rule per se of the system, I think I'm going to skip getting into another 55. Just don't feel like I want to go back to the well at that level for a third time. So it means that I'm going to wait until I could get into the 60. And that would mean a break above 57.50, because at that point, a break above that level would put me closer to the 60 than to the 55. So I'll just sit back and wait for a break of 57.50. My general thesis on not wanting to play the same strike too many times is because if SPX is going to trend higher, it's got to cross that point multiple times before it goes higher. So perhaps the third effort to go higher than that level will be successful. Just a theory. So we've got a new high here at 55.01. Again, just going to sit back and wait till it goes to 57.50, because then I would be closer to the 60, and I don't want to go back to the 55. So I'll just queue up a ticket here for the 60 level, and I'll wait for a break above 57.50. Now, if it never goes there, that would mean that the potentially here around this 55 area is the absolute high of the day, in which case being in a put at the absolute high of day would be a pretty good place to be with several hours still left in the trading day. But of course, I have no way of knowing if that is the case. Might be making a run here at 57.50. Got a new high at 55.73. It's got to go through that to get to 57.50. New high at 79, 55.79. All right, new high at 55.89. 56. So there's clearly, while the rules of the system are very straightforward to state, it's clear that there is some discretion in the system as well, because it's not every single new high that I'm trying to get into another trade. I mean, it's making new highs pretty much every few seconds here. But again, I said that I didn't want to get back into the 58.55, not because the system says anything about making a third trade at a particular strike, but just because my own common sense is telling me that if the index is going to trend higher, it's going to have to pass through that level again. If it does break through it and establish a new trading range above it, then I would end up being stuck in the 55. So just using my own discretion here, I've just decided not to take a third trade at that level. Although I do have two successful trades at that level so far. In fact, the only two successful trades so far have been at that level, if I remember correctly. So 55 bought to open, closed it out here for a profit, and then 55 here closed out for a profit, yes. So I don't want to go back to 55 again, but if I can get into the 58.60, I will. And since the idea is to get into the strike that's closest to the new high, in order for that to be the 60, the index would have to breach 57.50 to put the index closer to the 60 than to the 55. And it looks like that's where we're headed right now. Past 57.50. Almost there. So this downward movement here just reminds me of something, which is that I said I wanted to wait for a breakout above 5750 before getting into another trade because I wanted to get into the 5860. However, really, if that was my position, there really wasn't anything per se preventing me from getting into the 5860. For example, when it hit the 57. I think in at least one video last week, I was trading at a higher delta on the recommendation of another trader, and that certainly would have been a successful trade here at 5860, just looking at it. At any rate, at the next new high of more than 5702, that will certainly be an opportunity to get into the 5860. So I think what I'm going to do at this point is set up an alert so I can take my eyes off the computer. 5602. Want it to be greater than that and alert me if that should happen. right, well, I think that's a wrap.